Daryl has asked, what solutions do you use when you need to tap into a wire, a single wire in a harness, i.e. I often see Scotch locks or Posi-Tap connectors used. Yuck, no, definitely not. So this is an area where we do quite often see reliability problems creep in, where we've got an existing wiring harness and we need to break into that. Maybe we need to tap off an additional 12 volt or 5 volt feed. So what we quite often see is some nasty solutions like the Scotch locks that you've just mentioned. We don't want to do that. What we want to do is make sure that all of our wiring that we're adding is crimped and nice and reliable. So the solution here is we actually need to do this, or the easiest way of doing this is back at the ECU header. And what we're going to do is find the particular wire that we need to tap into. Let's say it's a 5 volt. We're going to extract that out of the ECU header plug. And we're going to then strip off a small section of the insulation somewhere on that wire. And then we can go onto that wire using one of our open barrel splicers. We're going to splice our new wire in there. And then we're going to still be able to seal that with our Raychem SCL to make sure that it is strain relieved and it is protected. We're not going to have any problems with a bare wire that's uninsulated.
That question was taken from one of our free live lessons. If you like free stuff and you're the type of guy that likes to expand his knowledge, click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson. You'll learn about tidally bundling a section of wiring harness, correctly splicing a single wire out to multiple wires that might need to head to the various sensors in your engine bay, and the materials and tools suitable for use in a motorsport environment. You'll also have the chance to ask your own questions, which I'll be answering live. Remember, it's 100% free, so follow the link to claim your spot.